Hi and welcome to this first GrandMA 3 tutorial. There's a lot of tutorials out there, but I wanted to start over and make the simplest form of tutorial that I could based on just starting the console up for the first time or the OnPC version up for the first time. So basically what we want to do to get started is to head over to malighting.com. I will drop a link down in the description below. So you can go in here and you can download the software. So start here with the downloads, click that one, go down to GrandMA 3 and click that one, and then you have software and release notes down here. So if you push this one, you will go down to the OnPC versions. There's two versions now compared to the GrandMA 2. The GrandMA 2 only had a Windows version, but GrandMA 3 comes out for Mac OS and Windows, which is really, really great. So depending on the operating system you have, download the correct version and install it. And when you have done that, close this one again, you will have this icon up here, GrandMA 3 on PC. So if you double tap that one, it will start up the application for the first time. So basically what I want to do in this first tutorial is just to make a brief run through and like tell you what is where if you compare to the real console. The first screen you're watching right here is the same as the screen number one over here on the right console. There's a few things missing down here right now, which is the encoder wheels and a lot of buttons, and they don't show up before you have patched a few fixtures. So right now it might look a little odd, but that is actually correct. To navigate around the console, we have on the real console, you have on the full size version, three major screens, three big screens. Right below that, you have three smaller screens. And below that on the surface itself, you have two small screens. So if you want to find those screens in the OnPC version, you simply click this button right here, which is the screens. And this will show you screen 1, 2, and 3. And this is 1, this is 2, and this is 3 on the full-size console. Then you have the option of two external screens here. External, which is screen output 4 and screen output 5. And then you have the two small screens, which you can see here on the real console, which doesn't which shows up on the GrandMA 3 full size console and the GrandMA 3 light console. I don't think it's on the smaller versions. So basically in the OnPC version you can choose what you want to see. So you can open the screen you want to see and want to work with. But screens is not all of it. Whoops. Up here, if you push that button, this one up here, that will open up the command section where you do all your programming, where you have all your buttons, your numeric keypad, your dimmers, and where you save, where you escape or press whoops or whatever. This is all hidden under this button here. Right below that one, you have a fader section, which is like your master controls, where you can set your selected masters. You can manipulate the grandmaster output, the world master, the highlight, the low light. There's loads of different options in here. Many of them I haven't really seen before in the GrandMA 2, so some of it is new. And during this tutorial series, we're going to look at most of it. Right below that one, you have your playback controls, which is your basically your first fader bank section, which you will find over here on the real console. So when you start saving executors and manipulate this will show up in this area right here. And right below that one, another master section, or custom master section as it is called. And this is also part of the desk's, what would you call it, default control that you can manipulate in here. You can set some rate masters, speed masters, and stuff like that. On the back side, or the rear side of the console, you have a lot of connectors that can do different things. So if we zoom in here, you will see starting from the left side, you have your desk light output. You have your power input for your PowerCon True One. You have your on and off switch, and then you have your six DMX outputs. That is the same amount of outputs as you had on the GrandMA 2. And right next to that one is your DMX input, which you can use right here. And you can configure all of them to be input or output. That depends on whatever you need to do. So the versatility in the desk is pretty amazing. Right next to that, you have your MIDI in and outputs. And right next to that, you have your timecode input. We will do a separate tutorial on timecode at a later point on this channel. You have your USBs everywhere, USB 2 and USB 3. And right next to that, you have your sound input, which you can use if you need to do some sort of sound to light. To the right side, you have your SPDIF in and outputs. And to the right again, you have your three Ethernet ports. On the GrandMA 2, you only had two Ethernet ports, two separate network cards. On the GrandMA 3, you have three separate network cards. As my understanding right now is that only one and two are active, where one is your MANet and your ACN, streaming ACN, and port number two is your MANet. I have heard rumors about port number three in terms of NDI or CE-Type-P or different other protocols, but I don't know if that's the case yet. At the top, you have your DisplayPort outputs for your external screens, so you can connect up to two external screens on the desk to give you more real estate for your buttons and for all your stuff and everything you want to see. When you open up the console like this, there's nothing in it. This is just a clean show. So in the next episode, we will be patching a few fixtures and we will be looking at different views and ways to manipulate them. So thank you for watching this episode. And if you find any value in this, please like the video, maybe even subscribe to the channel. That would help us a lot. And please, if you have any questions, leave a comment down below so we can answer them as good as we can. And that could be suggestions for future tutorials or whatever you need to talk about. So see you next time.